revenge time. I'm in your waterfall. I'm in your waterfall.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm with my sister.
Hi.
Mackenzie. And we look the same right now. No makeup.
No, I look really ugly right now.
Me
because
too.
I have no makeup on and I have like a couple pimples. So don't judge
me
what
too.
I look like.
So it's okay.
Shut up, you have no pimples.
Yes I do.
Shut up.
So anyways, I'm back with another video doing my sister's makeup because I enjoy doing her makeup and realistically I do it basically every day. So yeah, what I'm gonna be doing today is something that I never do, which is matte eyes and no shimmers. So,
wow.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay guys, so let's get into this tutorial. So first I'm gonna start with my Sisley Paris moisturizer. And this is more on the expensive side, but there are many dupes for this moisturizer, but I'm just gonna blend it in her face. Look very rough while doing it. But next I'm taking my favorite Mario Badescu facial spray and I'm just spritzing that all over her face to have a clean base. And now I'm taking my Tarte Shape Tape. Wow. I can't believe I just said that. But I'm taking that concealer in the shade Fair Light and then I'm just using the Sigma brush. I don't know what the number of it is. I'm sorry. But I'm just blending this in to act as an eye primer. And it's very full coverage and it mattifies, so it's perfect. Now on my Tarte lip palette, I'm just setting the eyes with the shade Charmer. And then to use as my transition colors, I'm using the two shades Flower Child and Sweetheart. And I'm using this Bedellium Tools just kind of transition brush. And I'm just going to blend that through the crease to act as a transition. Obviously, I just said that 900 times. Then I'm taking the shade Rebel. And I'm going to further deepen just the outer part of the eye. And I like how these shades are super, like, really warm toned and kind of reddish. They're super nice. Now I'm going to take the shade Leader. And by the way, I'm using these on my Real Techniques brushes. These are actually amazing and I love them. But what I'm doing with this shade is I'm kind of using it to act as an eyeliner in a way. And then smoking it out into the eyeshadow just to bring a little more depth. But yeah, that's basically what it is. Now I'm going back in with this little Charlotte Tilbury brush. It's like a pencil brush, I don't know. And the shade Flower Child again, just to put that on the inner corner of the eye. Then I'm taking the Ready Set Brow from Benefit. And this is just clear brow gel. And I decided not to fill her brows in today because she actually already has great brows. I wanted to keep it natural. So it's basically what I did. Those are the brows. I think they look pretty good. Now I'm just curling her lashes and then adding mascara. And I believe this mascara is called Better Than False Lashes Mascara from Too Faced. And I mean, look at her eyelashes. They're insane. They're beautiful. But yeah, so these are the eyes. Super simple, like basically nothing at all, but I like it a lot. Now I'm taking the NARS concealer in the shade Vanilla. And I'm just putting that a little tiny bit under the eyes. On the T-zone and where her redness spots are. And now I'm going to take my Giorgio Armani foundation in the shade 5.75 and I'm using a Real Techniques brush and I'm going to just blend the foundation like with the concealer. I'm going to blend them both together and I'm not blending it fully together. I'm just kind of giving it a really nice base. Then I'm going to take my Mario Badescu water again, and then I'm going back in with a beauty blender just to blend everything out to make sure there are no harsh lines and to make sure everything is super seamless. Now I'm taking the Laura Mercier translucent powder and just my Makeup Forever brush, and I'm going to quickly just set the under eyes. I'm not setting the whole face just because I don't want her to look cakey. Now I'm taking the Charlotte Tilbury sculpting bronzer. And the Ashley Tisdale Illuminate Cosmetics line to just bronze up her cheeks. Now I'm taking the Becca blush in the shade Pample Mouse, I think it is. Pample Mousse, I don't know. And then I'm going in with my Ashley Tisdale Illuminate Cosmetics blending brush. And then I'm going in with that Becca highlighter. This is Prosecco Pop, and I'm using my Tarte fan brush. And just placing this on the high points of her cheeks, above her brows, down the nose, and of course some on the Cupid's bow. And I think it looks beautiful. It just adds really nice light to her face. Now I'm taking my very disgusting and gross MAC lipstick called Velvet Teddy. And just putting that over her lips. And then I'm actually going back in with that Rebel shade and just going to smoke out the bottom lash line a little bit to bring it all together. Forgot to do this earlier, but I'm glad I remembered. But yeah. And lastly, I'm setting the face with the Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. But yeah, this is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed.
Alright guys, so that is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed. It's super, super natural, like always. And I'm sure you guys are gonna get mad that I always do natural looks. But, I mean, I'm 14 and she's 12, so we shouldn't really be doing too much of a heavy look. But yeah, it was cool doing just the matte eyes. I think it was something different and fun. And also, my sister and I, we filmed a video on her channel, and I'll link her channel in the description below. But you guys should go check this out after you watch this.
They already watched it if they're watching the ending. Good point.
So yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching. There'll probably be a part 3 to me doing Mackenzie's makeup, but till then, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!
Peace. Girl Scouts.
Peace out, Girl Scout.
I really want Girl Scout cookies. You know they have Girl Scout cereal?